Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today's video is going to be another Genshin Impact video, and today's is going to be kind of more so geared towards beginners. I've had a lot of friends, fellow content creators and streamers, but also a lot of people from like the Animal Crossing community switching over to Genshin and playing Genshin. And I was watching the streams of a couple of my friends who were really just trying out the game for the first time in the past week. And there were so many little things I was trying to explain to them just via like stream chat, but it really didn't make too much sense just trying to like tell them this information. So I hopped on a reroll account of mine from like launch day that I still have. And so I put myself in the shoes of an early game player, and I had a couple of those friends in chat with me, and I just had them ask me questions, maybe trying to figure out some of the things that they don't really understand, maybe some of the lingo that we tend to say as Genshin players who've been playing for a while now, and even trying to teach them the little like habits or kind of routines to set themselves up better in the future. Because I know there are things early on in the game that I kind of regret now not setting myself up for really early on. That way I had those routines and daily things just down packed, so that way I could future-proof myself once I got to higher adventure ranks. I personally felt like there were things that I could have done that I didn't figure out till way too late on in the game that I realized, oh, if I had been doing this since early days, since my early AR, I could have future-proofed myself for now. So I'm just gonna go over some of the basics for any newer players out there. But if you have been playing for even just a couple months, or even if you're a veteran, I hope you find this at least entertaining and maybe you'll learn something out of this. And I definitely plan to continue making a beginner series. And so if there's anything that was left out of this video that you want to know about, or if you have any questions, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. And while you're at it, please give this video a thumbs up and even a subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed. It really just does go a long way in helping out the growth of this channel. But let's just go ahead and get into some of the things that were specifically asked on that stream itself. So I think kind of one of the biggest things we tend to talk about as like higher AR level players and stuff like that is about resin. And I had actually quite a few people ask me, what is resin? How do I spend it, etc. And so as you can see here, I'm on my, like I said, like my reroll beginner account. I'm only AR 14 right now, haven't even unlocked co-op. And so basically I was trying to figure out actually what is the best ways to be using my resin. But let's just go ahead and get into what resin is in general. And so up here at the top of your map, you can see here, it says 85 out of 160. This is your resin. And kind of what I tell newer players is, if you see this at 160 out of 160, you need to go and start burning this resin. And if it's at 150, anywhere between 150 to 159, you need to run and just go ahead and start burning it. And the reason why I say this is because this is a very limited currency, especially later on. You're gonna wish you had spent more of this really early on. And why I'm saying that is because what resin does is that you're able to claim basically stuff from bosses, ley lines, and domains, but you have to use your resin for it. And you're only limited to, like I said, this 160 here. Now, of course, there's other things you can use, like fragile resins, which you'll gain over time. You can even use Primo Gems to actually increase your resin. But if you're a free-to-play player, or if you're trying to be a low spender, I don't recommend using your Primo Gems for this. If you're a whale, go for it. But really early on in the game, I think it was at like AR 8 is when I unlocked it. You unlock these things called ley lines here, which kind of on the map, they look like these kind of like foggy, I don't know, circular kind of things, icons on your map. But if you click it here, you can see that it says the ley line, outcrop, blossom of wealth. And you can see that there's the rewards here. And do you see this right here? The treasure collection cost is 20 resin. So when you go and do this, you're gonna fight a mob of like some enemies, but to claim the actual treasure from it, it takes 20 resin. And like I said, you only have 160 a day. Now what these yellow ones are gonna give you is it's gonna give you Mora, like it says here. It's also gonna give you AR rank bonuses. And so basically, if you go go to the yellow ones. What you're mostly going to get out of it is Mora. So there are those yellow ones, but then there's also these blue ones here. And what this is going to give you is character level up books. And that's how you're going to increase the level of your character. So what I'll say is get in the habit of burning your resin early. It's something that I didn't really take into consideration early on. I was just like, oh, let me just go ahead and run around, open up my map, do these kind of things. And I was just doing quests and exploring, and I know there were probably days, if not weeks, where I probably just didn't even touch my resin. And because of that, I've definitely missed out on a good chunk of Mora and also a good amount of books that I could have been using and really utilized, because later on in the game, it becomes really, really scarce to have those materials. Like I said, the further you progress, you're gonna be able to use this on stuff like bosses, and the boss claims even take 40 resin. So like I said, this is going to be a very limited resource that you only get so much per day, unless you refill it with fragiles, but I can make an entire video about that when you should actually be using it. Early game, I would really advise not to use stuff like your fragile resins to refill it. You will refill it by an extra 60 resin a day, but I would hold off on that until you're a little bit higher, because this will come in use so much more later on in the game for you. So that's the basic breakdown of resin, if you're a newer player and didn't know about that. Another tip that I want to give some newer players is about healing. As you can see, my main character Aether here is only at 100 HP. I was very surprised to know that some of my friends who've been playing for even weeks at a time did not know that you can heal by going to one of the statues of the seven. I'll talk in lengths about the statue here. So basically, if you interact with the statue of seven here, you can get the statue's blessing. And from here, you can just go ahead and heal your characters. But one other cool thing is that you can actually set an auto recover whenever you're nearby. So you can literally set this to 100. And as long as it has actual energy in here to actually heal your characters. So now that that is set to 100%, anytime you come near the Statue of the Seven, it's going to revive 100% of the character's HP, as long as there is like energy in the statue here, which does refill over time. The other thing about this statue that I want to mention is there's this thing called Worship the Statue here. And basically, you might have heard of these things, or you might have seen these things around your map, which are the Animoculus. You might have also seen Geoculus if you're farther enough and you're in Liyue already, but it says I own 5 of these here. And basically, you'll see these in the world. So as you're exploring Teyvat and you're just looking at your mini map, you might see a little star icon that pops up on it. That means there's one of these Oculus really close by. And I'm telling you, go ahead and pick that up. Like, drop kind of what you're doing and go ahead and find it, because this is what's going to actually be able to level up the statues. And what the statues are going to be able to do is level here up your stamina. It's also going to give you primo gems, but the big thing here is the stamina, because early game stamina is so bad. Oh my gosh, I did not realize how little the stamina bar is until like having played on my main account and just seeing how much I can actually run. That's a big thing that some of the newer players that I've been seeing play run into. They're just like, why don't I have enough stamina to climb and stuff? It's because you need to level your statue here, and you feed it the Animoculus for this one specifically. And so if I offer this up, it's going to increase, as it says right there on the screen, my max stamina from 122 to 130. And now I'm going to be able to run and climb a little bit more. And there were some other general questions about like what certain things meant when it comes to like character building, when it comes to like ascension, stuff like that. So I'm going to go ahead and click into the character menu here. And as you can see, I have my boy Aether here. He's only level 10 out of 20. I can level him up using these books. And like I mentioned, you can get these books by, well, you can do like chests, and you can get them from just doing chests, and you can get them from a ton of different ways. But another way you can get a lot of these really early on is by using your resin on those ley lines. So I can use this to level him up if I wanted to right now. I don't feel like it just in this moment, because one tip that I'm going to give is that kind of research, like, what characters do you have now? Maybe you've been saving up your primo gems to be able to pull on some character banners in the future, and think about, what characters do I actually want? Because those characters are going to need investment. They're going to need those books to be able to level them up. And if you're stuck and out of books because you've leveled up Amber to level 20 or to even 40, 60, etc., you might be a little upset. This is coming from someone who has leveled up a lot of characters who I regret because they sit the bench. So now I know better than to level Amber or like a Lisa, who I just know I'm not really going to use. Early game, I think you can get away with not leveling them. I know it's gonna take a while to beat the enemies and stuff like that, but invest in the characters that you want. I pulled a Rosaria recently, and so I am actually wanting to level her up. So I'm gonna level her to 20 right now. And so now I want to ascend her, but I have to wait till I'm adventure rank 15. So I think I'm only like one level away. But you can see beforehand what ascension materials you're going to actually need. And you're gonna see right here. So I need these right here, which are the Jade Silvers. And you can get this from a couple different ways, like it says right here. The Cryo Regisvine, which is a boss. The Cryo Hypostasis, which is a boss. Or you can purchase from the souvenir shop. Now there's two other materials she needs here, right? She needs the Valberries here, and this says found in the wild. Found on Stormbearer Mountain, so I could head over there and start finding stuff. And then I also need these recruiters insignias, which are dropped by skirmishers, agents, Sinsin mages, so I need to go find them in the world and go fight them to obtain those materials as well. Another character that I do actually really like though is Kaya, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you here something that I showed to the stream chat recently. So Kaya really needs calla lilies here, and so some of these materials, just FYI, they don't show up every day. You can't just go collect a ton of them, and there's usually only a limited amount of them that exist in the world per day. And sometimes some of these things don't even grow for 48 hours. I picked up some of these on stream, and I'm actually in the spot in the game where some of these calla lilies grow. Like, they do grow over here, but they're not here because I just picked them up yesterday. So I'm gonna go ahead and head to another spot where I know calla lilies spawn. I'm gonna just give you another tip in terms of exploration. All right, so I'm on this new spot on my map here, and as you can see, right over here, I have these calla lilies. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick these up because I know Kaya in the future is also gonna need these. So one thing that I need to do, this is one thing that I wish I had done earlier on when it came to these materials. I am gonna go ahead and head over to my map. And what I can do right now is I see my character on this spot right here. I can click on this and I'm going to be able to set a pin. Just FYI, you can set a pin anywhere you want. If I wanted to, for some reason, I could set a pin right here. But I'm going to go ahead and put it on the spot that I'm standing on. Now there's all these different icons I can set the pin to as well, right? But I'm going to set it to this flower because that's what I picked up, is one of the flower materials. And what's really nice is that you can edit the name of this. So now I can go ahead and just put in calla lily here. And now I know, I'm going to store this in my mind, but now I know that every 48 hours, I can head to this spot right here and I can go pick up those two calla lilies. So when I have some extra downtime, if I'm not doing quests, if I'm not going and exploring new regions, and if I'm not burning my resin, because I've already burned it by this point, I know to head over to the spot and grab the calla lilies. And I'm gonna go ahead and say, marking spots on your map is so vital and crucial. There's going to be puzzles that you run up against. There's going to be animoculus that feel a little bit like out of the way, or it's too much of a hassle to try to figure it out. So I would go ahead and recommend, if you see something in the wild and you can't figure it out at the moment, if you can't figure this puzzle out, or even if it's something like a material, make sure to put down a pin. I cannot stress this enough. This is so incredibly helpful, and you can always take pins away too. So say I didn't need calla lilies anymore, I can just go ahead and delete that pin if I wanted to. These are just small quality of life things that are going to set you up for success later on, especially when you need these materials. You just know exactly where they are because you've pinned them on your map and you can navigate towards them. And another perfect example as I exit out of here is that if you look on my mini map at the top right, you can see there's that star icon there. And that's what I talked about for the animoculus. I actually believe I can't get to this one because it's way up at the top here right now. And then this area is surrounded by a barrier. So I think I actually have to do the quest in order to go ahead and get that one first, because yep, I just get knocked back if I try to approach. So I can't get that one. So basically, I'm just gonna go ahead and head into here. I'm gonna give this a star because I think that icon makes a lot of sense. And I'm just gonna put an oculus there, and I'm just gonna save that. So now I know I can come back there and there's an animoculus. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and try to speed up the next part that I'm talking about, because I just don't want this video to be a whole entire documentary at this point. So I'm just gonna go back into the character screen and explain a couple things really quickly. One thing that you might hear a lot is C something. So you'll usually hear like, oh, Kaya C5, or you might hear Lisa C3 or something like that. And a lot of people in my stream chat were asking, Well, what does that mean? What do C's mean? What do R means? So what a C means is constellation, okay? And there's actually a tab over here on the left that says constellation here. And then the number means is how many copies essentially of that character you've pooled. So every character kind of starts as C0. So for example, I've Amber, which everyone does when we get her, she's actually C0, because if I go into her constellations, none of these are opened up here. Now, when I was pooling, I pulled another copy of Kaya. So I actually have a C1 Kaya here. And basically what this does is that this unlocks certain abilities that are locked behind pulling multiple copies of a character. So I know there's probably some new players who pulled multiple copies of the same character and are mad because they want all these different characters. They want all the different characters that are available, right? Well, it actually is kind of beneficial for the most part to get these multiple copies because it's going to unlock these multiple constellations. So right now, I would say I have a C1 Kaya, and C1 Kaya is actually really great because if I look into this ability, it says the crit rate of Kaya's normal and charge attacks against opponents affected by cryo is increased by 15%. I know for some of the early game players, all of that language might be like, what are you even talking about? And I can do an entire video breaking down what some of these like theories mean, kind of like how to boost your stats, damage, etc. I just kind of want to go over some basic things right now. So essentially that's what C is. It's just in reference to how many constellations you have of a certain character. Some characters are very hard to get their constellations no matter how much you wish and you pull for them. Some constellations are given to you for free. And even if you go into like the shop area, you can actually see that sometimes depending on how much currency you've built up, you can actually buy certain characters, but this is if you have a certain amount of this currency, which is the star glitter here, which I don't on this account because I haven't wished very much. So it's usually every 30 days that this rotates out, and there's always going to be some 4-star characters on here that you can buy a copy of. So you can get your first copy of them through this way, or you can get a constellation for them through there. Now, some constellations are going to be stronger than others and make more sense for others. And I know really early on, it can be kind of overwhelming hearing why you need C3 of this or C4 of that one. But to be honest, a lot of characters really are good at base still. So even if you have, say, a C6 4-star character, if you like another character more, it's okay. And if you want to play that other character more, that's totally fine as well. I personally subscribe to playing this game exactly how you want to and playing the characters that you personally like, maybe even just aesthetically or just based on how their kit works. So that's a very, very brief rundown of what C's are or constellations are. The other thing you might be hearing is R and a number. So similar to like, oh, you might hear a C2 something. You might hear R5 something else. What that's in reference to is weapons. So everything that has an R is going to be in terms of a weapon. So as you can see right here, I have a prototype Rancor on Kaya, and right there it says it's refinement rank 1. That's what R1 means. So the refinement rank is what the R stands for, and whatever the number is, this is just again another how many copies have you gotten of this specific weapon. For example, if I go over to my Rosaria here, as you can see, refinement rank 5 for this black tassel. That basically just means I've collected 5 of these black tassels, because they're actually a very easy weapon to get early on in the game. So let's say you pulled multiple copies of the same weapon, you just go and equip it, and then you go to enhance here, and on the black tassel you just go to the refine. Now it says it's max refined because R5 is the highest you can go for a weapon. There's nothing more that you can refine. You can obviously level up the weapon still, but you can't refine it more than that. So let me just go ahead and find and show an example here. As you can see, Kaya, who's a sword user, and I have 2 of these Skyrider swords here, right? So let me just go ahead and hit enhance on this Skyrider sword. What I can do is I can go to refine right here, identical weapon materials, and I see that there's another Skyrider sword. So I can just go ahead and click on that and hit refine, and it sends it to refinement rank 2. And essentially what this does, as you can see here, using an elemental burst grants 15% attack increase and movement speed for 15 seconds. So just make sure to read what some of these things are. So if I got another Skyrider sword, as you can see right here, it says on the next rank, using the burst is increased by 18% in terms of my attack and my movement speed. I think one thing that's hard for a lot of players early on is the amount of reading you do have to do. I know sometimes, especially with this story, there's a lot of fluff in it, and so it's easy to just kind of skip past things. But I would really recommend reading what these do early on so that way you can start grasping some of the terminology, some of just like what these things are doing. I know there's a lot of information that's already in this video, and there's so much more to explain as well, but I'm gonna keep trying to make videos like this that explain these things more thoroughly. Now, the last thing I'm gonna touch on just very, very, very briefly, because I can do an entire deep dive into what these actually do, why these are so crucial, why they're talked about so much, but it is about artifacts, because I think there is a large body of Genshin players who talk about artifacts, and new players have no idea what they're getting into when it comes to artifacts. I'm just gonna go ahead and say as a disclaimer, if you are new to the game, really don't worry about this too much. I'm talking like before AR like 40 even, don't worry about your artifacts too much. And even then, I would mostly recommend not even caring that much about artifact hunting and stuff like that until you hit AR 45. But I'm talking really early game here. I'm talking AR, what, like 5 to like even 25, 30-ish here. I don't know. These 2-star and 3-star artifacts, they don't matter that much. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you, don't really invest in leveling these up. I know sometimes for like adventure book and stuff like that, it's gonna tell you to, so you can go ahead and do that, but don't worry about leveling some of these things up early on, because I just don't think things are that hard where you specifically need it. But the quickest rundown of artifacts is that it basically gives you some extra boosted stats. So I'm actually gonna switch over to Aether here because he has no artifacts on him, and just kind of show you from start to finish what kind of artifacts do very early on. But basically, as you can see here on the right hand side, there's just kind of like different bonuses that you get depending on these sets. But before I get to that, every single artifact will have a main stat and some sub stats, and then it's gonna have its set bonus. So right here, you can see the main stat of this is HP. Now, flowers here are always going to be HP. Feathers are always going to be attack. And it gets a little bit tricky when it comes to stuff like your sands, when it comes to your goblet, and when it comes to your circlet. Like I said, I can create an entire deep dive breakdown of what these things are for a future video, because it's gonna take way too long to really explain all this stuff right now. But basically, these last three have a kind of a plethora of different main stats that it can be. So up at the top, like I mentioned, is the main stat. What these little ones here are the substats. The substats matter a ton as well. And then down here is the set bonus. So let's say if I had 2 Berserker pieces here, it's going to increase my crit rate. So let me just go ahead and like steal this Berserker piece here, right? And then I'm pretty sure, yep, over here I have another Berserker piece that's a HP mask. This really isn't a good piece at all. I'm just equipping it just to show you. So if I equip this, now it says that there's 2 here. So now I have the 2 piece set is activated. And so now my character has an increase in crit rate by 12%. So one thing, if you didn't know, if I'm here in attributes, I can go and click on details. And right now his crit rate is 17. So basically, if I just go ahead and go back here, let's say I remove this. I'm gonna go back into my attributes and details, and as you can see now, my crit rate is only 5. The quickest way to explain crit rate and crit damage, these are always topics that you're gonna hear about, especially the later on in the game you get. Critical rate is essentially how often you might be getting a critical hit. And then the crit damage is how much your normal damage does, but when you do get that crit, how much of an increase you're going to get. So these are always really good stats that you want to get higher and higher up, because you want to be doing more damage. That's kind of like the goal. So that way you can continually be doing DPS, which is another term that's talked about a lot in this community. DPS standing for damage per second. You tend to hear people talking about their characters as being their main DPS or a sub DPS. I can go again to another full breakdown video of what those things mean as well in a future video. But coming back to artifacts, that's essentially what it does. These are just going to boost certain stats very early game. I'm talking really early game. If you've only been playing for a month, maybe even 2 months, don't worry too much about this. When it comes to artifacts, there's a lot of reading involved, a lot of like theorizing that you have to do in terms of like putting bonuses together. You really don't need to worry about a lot of this stuff until later on in the game. Work on the things I talked more so about earlier on in this video in the start of your game, and I think you're gonna be able to future-proof yourself a lot better. Spending resin every single day so that way you can accumulate more mora and you can get more books for your characters. Make sure you're pinning things on your map. And also, essentially, if you see anything out in the world that's a little bit shiny, if you see something in the world that's shining, like even that butterfly over there, collect it. collect everything that you see in this game. There's chests in the world. There's even a Sealy over there that I can see. Follow those things. Basically, early on, have a lot of fun. Explore the world. This game is so incredibly stunning and beautiful. And always remember to play the characters you enjoy, regardless of what people say about if that character is good or not. But I'm just gonna go ahead and wrap up this video right here because I've been talking for a long time. There's way more we can cover. If you're a newer player, let me know in the comments, what are some other things you've been hearing from the community or just in the game in general that's just not really clicking for you? So that way I can make guides, tutorials, and just other tips, especially if you're a beginner player. I know I'm still newer to the game. I've only been playing for 4 months, and I definitely feel like I'm learning something new every single day. And I just want to help and make sure the people that are starting out set themselves up in the future so that we don't run into being at AR-55 and being completely broke out of Mora like I am. But thanks so much for watching. Again, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Just does go a long way in helping out the growth of this channel. As always, huge shout out to my channel members. It's because of you and your continued support that I can continue to create content like this on this channel. If you want to support the channel directly by becoming a member, you should see a join button next to subscribe. There's also a link in the description below if you don't see it. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.